Ladies and gentlemen, the mining flash is back, and I welcome there, not in BC, but with BC background, Peter Hawley, CEO of Fabled Copper. Nice to see you, Peter, for an update.
Absolutely excellent to see you too, Jan. And yes, this is the Musqua project behind me.
Very nice. Peter, you reported the results from the summer program of last year recently, and you continue to do that from the Musqua project. And there was one press release from the 11th of March about the Davis Keys Eagle vein. And I found this of particular interest because it seems that you extend the known deposit or the known vein. Let me show a picture first and then I need your comment, okay?
Sure.
Here's the press release with the picture, the Eagle vein, and an edit. This vein was known, but you made new discoveries, and this seems to be a parallel structure. Please tell us about your new findings.
What we found out, Jan, and this is really interesting. I'm actually really happy that you brought this up. Originally, there was the Eagle vein, which went right through the mountain from one side to the other side. And you're looking at the north side right here. And on the south side is all the switchbacks and the various levels going in, et cetera, et cetera. And this goes right through the mountain, and they've developed it, and they've outlined tons and reserves and resources in the 70s, et cetera, et cetera. But through our work last year, between doing the drone surveys and doing the field mapping and the geophysics, is we found six other parallel veins. So it's a vein swarm, it's not one. And in addition to that, one of them responded very well to VLF Fraser filter anomaly. So our plan for 2022, of course, is drilling. And I can assure you that the first drill hole will go through this set of veins. And it's really quite important in the sense that you already have this underground development. If you have other parallel veins not far away, it's very easy to take a 90-degree turn and go over onto those veins underground. So just like our old days in Mexico, Yan. So it's a great discovery. And then on a bigger picture in the area on the structural survey, we now understand the structural kinetics behind why this is happening. So, I'd consider it a fairly major breakthrough.
And more recently, there was another announcement about the Bronson project. That is the southernmost part of Musqua. And I think those were the first news releases about this property at all. And there, especially the book 6 showing. I'd like to show another picture and then tell us about your findings there. Mineralized vein of book 6, and it looks really impressive. Please tell us what your findings of book 6 were.
Well, book 6 has never been drilled. It actually outcrops out of the surface, sort of like a beached whale bones sticking along the surface. And you can follow it for 1.6 kilometers. Yeah. So on the Book 6 area, not only did we fly it with a UAV drone mission, again, we did the geophysics. And again, we channel sampled the whole length of it and a structural interpretation of what's going on. What has happened and everything else is that these are old historical names, so I didn't give them names, but there's another occurrence and it's called the Book 9-10. So, you know, what happened to 7 and 8? I have no idea, but Book 9 and 10, they're on strike. And from evaluations of those and everything else, we believe that Book 9 and 10 is actually Book 6. It's just a continuation of it, that's all. And that would put it over 3 kilometers. So, you know, that's a pretty big vein system that's going to running over 3 kilometers. So, yes, very interesting. Yeah.
So we have a lot to drill, Peter. And this brings me to a general question, because we know that the market for juniors is rather tough at the moment. The question is now, do you rather focus on known deposits like Eagle and Magnum, or do you also spend money on greenfield or brand new discoveries?
Well, we're doing both right now. Field season did begin at the beginning of June. I get my weekly reports, actually. I got this week's yesterday. And again, as before, it's helicopter support. So they have chased down some, let's say, structural anomalies that we were interested in already, and with great success, which you'll hear about later on in the season. And in addition to that, the main focus is the preparation for a drill program, Jan. And we've gotten notification from the British Columbia Mines Department for posting a bond. It's a reclamation bond for your drill sites that you have to clean them up. And so we've done that. And when they ask you to post a bond, you're not far away from, you know, receiving the permit. So right now, I believe they're in consultation with the Fort Nelson's First Nations. And we have a great relationship with them. So, you know, the stage is set for drilling this year. Accommodation logistics have already been worked out. You know, we're ready. Everyone's ready, actually.
Great. Thank you for the update, Peter. And then I expect many brand new drill results from BC. Oh, have a great weekend.
Okay, you too, sir.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye.